What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. It's been long. Hope you're all doing well. I hope you're enjoying your 2021. So you know what's going on, you know, back on the rainbow energy vibes, you know what I'm saying. If it's your first time here, I'm Tanaya. You can follow me on Instagram at tin.aye_linkinbio. Make sure to like the video, hit that thumbs up button, you know what I'm saying, and subscribe to my channel if you like my content, and be sure to check out the songs I recorded in my previous uploads. Okay, now let's get to the video. Let's go, boy. So today I'm going to be talking about lukewarm Christians. I may have a feeling that some of you might get upset because of this video. Some of you might even just hate me, but I don't really care, so I'ma go on making it anyway. So most people may wonder, what is a lukewarm Christian, or you can refer to as a worldly Christian. A lukewarm Christian is basically a person who says they're a Christian and then they go on living their sinful lives and doing the exact opposite of what Christians do, doing the exact opposite of what God tells them to do. These are basically people who love God half-heartedly and they love the world and the things of the world too. These types of people wanna fit in at church and they wanna fit in the outside world with everyone else. James 4 verse 4 tells us, "Don't you know that friendship with the world is hatred towards God? If you want to be a friend of this world, you make yourself an enemy of God." Lukewarm Christians say they love God, but they do not obey God or have any true affection for Him. They just say they love God just for the sake of saying it, because it makes them feel safe that they are saved, but that's just not the truth. Revelation 3 verse 15 to 16 says, "You are neither hot nor cold. I wish that you were one of them. But since you're lukewarm water, I will spit you out of my mouth," which simply means if you're a lukewarm Christian, you will not go to heaven. You will go to hell and you will burn. Yeah, that's just the truth, bro. That's the truth. I'm being straight up with you. Matthew 15 verse 8. "These people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far away from me." That's exactly how lukewarm Christians are. They say they love God, but deep down they don't really love God.
"Nah, it's okay. God will forgive me. Blah, 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 blah."
That type of Christianity is dangerous. And if you keep living your sins, lying to yourself like that, then you won't make it, bro. You need to repent. You will not make it to heaven if you continue like this. If you're not sure, or if you want to be sure that you're a lukewarm Christian or not, here's a list I found of 10 different signs that you're a lukewarm Christian. By the way, I didn't write these. Number 1. Lukewarm people attend church fairly regularly and sing worship songs, but don't even think about what they're hearing or singing. It is what is expected of them, what they believe good Christians are supposed to do. They go to church and check off the box. 2. Lukewarm people give money to the charity and to the church as long as it doesn't impose on their standard of living. If they have a little extra and it is easy and safe to give, they do so. After all, God loves a cheerful giver. 3. Lukewarm people tend to choose what is popular over what is right when they are in conflict. They desire to fit in both at church and the outside of church. They care more about what people think of their actions, like church attendance and giving, than what God thinks of their hearts and lives. 4. Lukewarm people don't really want to be saved from their sin. They only want to be saved from the penalty of their sin. They don't genuinely hate sin and aren't truly sorry for it. They merely sorry because God is going to punish them. Lukewarm people don't really believe that this new life Jesus offers is better than the old sinful one. 5. Lukewarm people are moved by stories of people who do radical things for Christ, yet they do not act. They assume such actions are for extreme Christians, not average ones. Lukewarm people call radical what Jesus expected from all his followers. Lukewarm people rarely share their faith with their neighbors, co-workers, or friends. They do not want to be rejected, nor they want to make people feel uncomfortable by talking about private issues like religion. 7. Lukewarm people gauge their morality or goodness by comparing themselves to the secular world. They feel satisfied while they aren't as hardcore for Jesus as so-and-so. They are nowhere as horrible as the guy down the street. Lukewarm people say they love Jesus and he is indeed a part of their lives, their money and their thoughts, but he isn't allowed to control their lives. 9. Lukewarm people love God, but they do not love him with all their heart, soul and strength. They would be quick to assure you they try to love God that much, but that sort of total devotion isn't really possible for an average person. It's only for pastors, missionaries, and radicals. Lukewarm people love others but do not seek to love others as much as they love themselves. Their love for others is typically focused on those who love them in return, like family, friends, and other people they know and connect with. There's little love left over for those who cannot love them back, much less for those who intentionally slight them or with whom conversations are awkward or uncomfortable. Their love is highly conditional, very selective, and generally comes with strings attached. Now I'm gonna stop there because I'm only doing 10 of these, but there are like 8 more that are very useful. So I'm going to leave the link in the description so you guys can also read it for yourselves. Now while I was reading from this document, if you felt kinda angry or upset, or if you paused the video and thought to yourself, I kinda do this, did you sit there and try to justify? Well, that means there's something that you need to change. Stop being lukewarm and bring your heart closer to God, because time's running out and we're living in the end times. These are the times the devil's gonna try his best to bring as many people down with him, because he knows his time is up. So these are the times we should be on fire for the Lord more than ever. God bless you.